What's going on, guys? DK back with another Last Cloudia video. Today we are going over the news from the Last Cloudia team. They're going to be talking about the new collab and what's going to be coming along with it. Just before we start the video, guys, I want to make sure that you guys go ahead and check out the video yourselves, like and subscribe to the Aidis channel. I'm sure that anything will help them. But yeah, make sure you guys check that out. If you do stop, you know, you see this video before you see theirs, make sure you go ahead and stop by their stuff and give them a shout out and stuff like that. So pretty exciting stuff. We have the collab coming out along with the new characters. It looks like it will be split up into two parts. This video is about 20 minutes long, so I will stop it for like important information if you guys already haven't watched it. But I'll try to maybe explain some stuff as far as what's going on. Just to give you guys a heads up, I will be throwing out a Kawaku video in the next couple of days, just to kind of get ready for the collab as far as, 'cause that's actually the only character I was able to obtain. So if you guys do pull her, I'll show you how I have built her and you know, where to go from there. So make sure you guys check out that. If you like today's content, go ahead and like and subscribe. But let's go ahead and get this video rolling.
Hello,
all right. Oh, that's one dope ass background.
Translation team leader and promo guy Kit.
Producer の竹さんです。本日もよろしくお願いします。いやー、あれだね。まずこう環境がね、今日全然違うよね。まあ、いつもね、こう白いこう背景にポスターを貼ってね、お送りしてましたけど、今日はもう豪華な感じでね、お送りしていきます。同期と。
Oh, I mean, you know, I've never seen anything like this before.
じゃあ今日も情報とたっぷり お伝えしていきますので、よろしくお願いします。
Alright, so here's a look at everything that we're going to cover in today's video. I want to let you know all about the Dr. Stone collab that we announced on February 22nd.
あ、そうだね。あの、今日ね、だいぶ詳細をお伝えできるんで、やっと詳細ね、お伝えできて。はい、やっていきましょう。
Yeah, absolutely. We've got a ton of information to share with you about the Dr. Stone units, ARKS, and event. And this time around, everyone who plays is guaranteed one of 5 collab units. So be sure to stick around to the end.
So guys, we're going to go ahead and he's going to talk about, I guess, the story of the Dr. Stone. Like I said, make sure if you guys want to check that out, make sure you guys check out their actual video. But we're going to go ahead and skip it just to keep this video a little short. We're just going to go ahead and go over like the main information.
After a sudden and mysterious incident, human civilization, facing a stone world where humanity seemingly collapsed, awakens from the past.
Alright guys, so they're gonna show us the characters. I'm gonna start with Senku. Let's actually back up a little bit so we can see that.
Alright. Kayaku だな。
気合を入れろ。逃がさんぞ。甘い。勝負ありだ。今だ。私に任せろ。
She is one hell of a character, guys. Still to this day.
日々の鍛錬の成果だな。
やはり戦うしかないのか。
これが武力だ。邪魔させない。全力で行く。
苦しみは与えない。さよならだ。これが純粋な力だ。ラストクラウディア。
テンション上がる。ああ、いいね。あのね、今回その千空と琥珀と、まあ、司ね。復刻ということなんですけども、まあ、アニメを見てるからか、まあ、むちゃくちゃこう欲しくなったね。やっぱりね。どう来てた。
Absolutely, you know, I was not able to get some of them last time around, and I cannot wait this time. This time is going to be my time.
テンション上がってるのすげえっすね。今回、あの、復刻でね、改めてガチで追加っていうところ
。I love Take-san's energy, man. It's so positive.
情報修正していきますので、これはね、後ほど、まあ、キットの方から紹介してもらいますので、はい、よろしくお願いします。
All right, so first we're going to start going into a little bit of detail about Senku Ishigami. He's a dyed-in-the-wool young scientist who's extremely curious. He has an extraordinary intellect and abundant knowledge, and in Last Cloudia in particular, he can seriously buff himself in units using the power of science. Mm. This time around, and Take-san mentioned this a little bit just a moment ago, but this time around, Senku's stats are going to be raised for the re-release of the collab event. His science user trait will now boost the magical damage cap and casting speed for the first time. The Kingdom of Science trait also now buffs allies' criticals in addition to skills and magic, and it's more effective than ever before. Alright, so following up on that, we have Kohaku. She's a young girl with blonde hair and blue eyes, and she's also one of my favorites. Agile and experienced in combat because of her skills in hunting, as well as sparring with other members of the village. You know, and last, Cloudia, she's a speedy attacker with an overwhelming number of hits. Her quick reactions mean that enemies don't have a chance to counterattack. Okay, so Kohaku is going to be buffed for the collab's re-release as well. Her companionship trait allows her to share HP with allies, as well as gain a fixed amount of HP. That means that she'll be easier to use than ever before.
Damn, that's going to be rad.
Her is also going to see some additions, Fighting Spirit 3 and other attacks. Her exclusive skills will also be a lot more powerful than they were in the past. All right, and we have, as the third of our returning units, Dukasa Shishio, the strongest high school primate. Whoa. He's a young man equipped with enough power to take down lions with his bare hands. You know, and here in Last Cloudia, he's a powerful attacker who can stand up to the harshest blows. Now, to be outdone by the other units, Dukasa will be buffed this time around. His strongest primate trait will now be effective against humans when physically attacking. The in-one-blow trait will now boost critical damage cap. In addition, max HP will be increased, and additional skills will be added to the ability board. Resolve Up 3 and Royal Armor will be there to boost his defense.
はい、じゃあ今回ね、復刻ということで、さらに追加される、天空と琥珀とね、司に関してまずキットから紹介していただきましたけども、まあ、情報修正も入りますのでね、はい、ぜひ各ユニット。
All right, so let's pause that for a second. So it looks like we're getting buffs to all three characters.We're going to have Senku, as we're going to have an increase in magic cap, hopefully, as from what I, or what, kind of what they got from that. As you guys know, he is our only science user in Las Cloudia as of right now. So if you guys aren't aware, Senku is a beast of a character. He keeps your team alive. He deals damage. I mean, he kind of does it all. Definitely one of my top characters. As far as the buffing and healing side, just a really cool unit overall. Then we have Kohaku just annihilating the board with, you know, abundance of hits. We're also probably getting a cap on her as well. Maybe we'll be hitting that 1299 range. And then with all the other stuff that we have now, we can buff her even more. The fact that she's even helping out as a boost for HP on allies, which is pretty rad. I can't wait to see that. And I'll, they're not even super specific on what she's going to be, what's going to be added to her board. So, you know, guys, you know, she's already going to be really exciting for the players that already have her. Tsukasa wasn't able to get him last year or much play with the character, but I have seen a couple of videos on him, and he kind of reminds me of Kraven the Hunter from that Spider-Man. So he just looks really, and the fact that they said taking down bears and stuff like that, that's really cool. But yeah, the fact that he's getting royal armor and I believe he said fighting spirit, that's going to be really cool. And then I'm sure they're going to throw in some other stuff as far as buffs. So Royal Armor is going to fit perfectly, so you're going to have that DPS slash kind of tank guy. So I'm really excited to see what they're going to do with him. But yeah, let's kind of move on.
She's
adorable.
Yeah, she's one of my favorites. Definitely, for sure.
Well, yeah, that's about it right now for the units that are going to be re-released. Now I'd like to get into the new units that are going to be coming just this time around. Let's take a look first at Gen Asagiri.
Oh, let's go, let's go, let's see this character.
Last Cloudia.
Their face.
Yeah, we have him there, Gen Asagiri. You know, he's a shallow, smooth talker whose words have no weight. His exceptional speaking abilities and thorough preparation fool his opponents. Here in Last Cloudia, this excellent mentalist's powers work on both friend and foe. His unique powers allow him to carry battles by shutting down enemies' offense, while giving a leg up to allies. For example, his Shallow Words ability is a first in that it restores all allies' SCT. Additionally, he can flip enemies' buffs to debuffs with his sleight of hand ability. I don't know.
Wow.
It's pretty impressive, isn't he?
ゲンはさ結構ちょっとさ今回そのスキルとかさ、まあ、スキルの名前もそうなんですけど効果も特徴的だなと思ってて、まあ、メンタリストっていうね名がねもうこうしっかり箱入ってるんでもうゲンらしいこうキャラクター設定パラメーターになってるんでねむちゃくちゃ楽しみだなというふうに思って。
So now with Gen there, let's go on to our next unit, Chrome.
Let's just kind of talk about Gen. So judging by what I see, they don't really talk too much about percentages. But judging from the character, he can push characters back, enemies back. And then you saw several debuffs happening with that S4. I saw maybe some kind of like magic barrier, maybe magic castle style. I don't know. He's going to be really interesting as far as like the debuffs go. I wonder what the percentages are going to be, but looks like we're getting a pretty unique character on that side. I'm actually pretty excited to test him out. So let's kind of move on to see what Chrome's going to be like.
Oh.
Okay, and now here we have our second new unit. He's a young man who's curious, intelligent, and has a genuine personality. After meeting Senku, he became fascinated with science and worked to help establish and expand the Kingdom of Science. So, here in Las Cloudia, his resource collecting trait gives him a chance to get items from the enemy at the start of battle. He's nimble and he's able to make use of both flame and thunder skills to defeat enemies efficiently. We can't share a video of Chrome with you just yet, but we'll be posting it to social media before long.
Damn.
So be sure to check it out.
Chrome はさ、やっぱこのスキル今紹介したけども、そのバトル開始にさ、まあドロップがさ、こうアイテムが得られる。これがとてもやっぱ便利だよ。
Alright, so we got another thief slash farming unit. This time we're looking, and we kind of talked about this, where he's going to be our first magical attack thief, but the fact that he can drop items every round is insane because it doesn't say once per quest like Beast Hunter is. It says start of battle, which means it could be start of every round. So that just, man, I feel like this is the farmer we need and the farmer everybody's going to want to get, but it's going to be, you know, a hard one. So I'm kind of glad that he's not just a regular DPS guy. I feel like we have so many DPS, so many magic DPS people. I'm glad to see that we're getting something a little bit more unique so that he is played more often. So that's why I feel like we're in a kind of a weird direction to where we have so many units and we're just like, well, who do we want to use? Like, you know, I'm even in that point to where I don't know who to use. So at this point, I'm kind of just randomly picking people just to play in fights. Like the other day, I used Celios in the Zaylork fight just for fun, just to see how he did. So, you know, it's fun to pull these, you know, that we're going to get a unit that we will most likely be using on the daily for farming and for, you know, events and stuff like that. So this is going to be an awesome unit, guys. Go ahead and start this. Stoked for this character. I hope I get him because I need a new farmer.
All right, I'd now like to share a little bit about the ARKS that will be returning for our Dr. Stone
Club. I'm really digging this background and the fact how they're transitioning in and out.
This ARK can teach science skills and it's useful for dealing with status ailments. The character who's equipping it gets plus 20% strength, and is able to neutralize other basic status ailments. Just as in the initial release of Science User from Another World, you'll be able to get this ARK just for playing. If you don't have it yet, be sure to pick it up. Okay, and then we have here is our second ARK, the Light of Science. This ARK has loads of powerful science skills. Its trait shortens science magic casting time and reduces the MP used by 2. Whenever you use magic, all allies will recover a little bit of HP. Following that, we have the SSR ARK, the Spring of Sulfuric Acid. This ARK is able to weaken foes.
Nice, we're going to go ahead and stop that real quick because more likely they'll transition that pretty quickly. So we have ARK attributes, continuous HP drop, but when physically attacking, lower enemy resistance, minus 20, and inflict damage. That's pretty cool if resistance is at least 1. Oh, that's one sentence. Oh, lower elemental resistance, minus 20, and inflict damage if resistance is less than 1. Or at least at 1. Okay, got it. When defeating an enemy, recover SCT and 10% HP. Can't go wrong with that. Strength and Sulf skill and low chance to for instant death. Okay, cool. Excludes bosses and arenas, blah, blah, blah. But this is where it gets really interesting on these skills. So we have super bad chemical drain and super bad chemical fatigue. Looks like we are going to be able to nerf the enemy strength, INT, defense, and magic defense, all with just 2 skills. I'm probably going to say around maybe 9 SC per skill. So it's going to be pretty costly, but for someone like Senku, or maybe you can even swap out some stuff for like maybe Theria or Tinkili. There's a lot of things you can throw that with, and maybe just a random character, just kind of throw that on there, have like a team that has one and the other, and you can make sure to launch those off right at the start of the match, so we can kind of, you get that, those instant debuffs for the enemies. So those are going to be really good and beneficial for the characters. And then we have Cure All of Science. It's pretty simple. Poison, blindness, silence, curse, illness, and stun. It cures it all. Hydrogen sulfide, powerful ice attack in a wide area. That's going to be interesting, because actually I've been wanting to look at more ice attacks. And maybe this one will have a cool animation. So that's going to be really exciting. I was reading this a minute ago, and it said gas mask. Battle start, activate a barrier that nullifies basic status ailments once, and it is permanent. So although it probably wouldn't work the best in the arena, because in the arena you do start off with zero MP, so you would have to, unless it's a cost of zero, then you most likely will get instant ailments on PvP, PvP, Battle Arena. So that looks like it's going to benefit more of the enemies and, you know, the boss fights and stuff like that. So that's going to be fantastic. Then we have Sulfurina. More likely to be targeted by enemies, continuously deal dark damage to enemies that are near. Most likely to be targeted. I guess that would be good for maybe Tsukasa, because they kind of make it on like kind of a tank. So that'd be kind of interesting to have, you know, especially if you're using like some kind of sorcerer, or V as a sniper. You kind of pull the attention away from the enemies, and they'll be targeted to the tank. So that'd be pretty neat to see. Hopefully the percentages are there, but let's go ahead and jump on this
skills
a little bit more.
Whenever a character equips it, their HP will constantly drop. However, when physically attacking an enemy, that enemy will get minus 20 to any attribute resistances that
I love have. That art, though. And look at that arc, though.
Deal damage to them as well. I don't know. Those are two great arcs, and I can't
that's
wait.
So cool.
あの、そうだね。特に紹介したいのはこの あの、登場した、まあ、アークになるんですけども、こっからに関してはね、新アーク2つを紹介していきたいと思います。
Okay, and here we go with something really exciting.
Getting new LRs. Holy.
The Empire of Might. It's an LR arc that enhances dark physical attacks.
Look at that arc, guys. That is so cool.
Stones, while also having an arc trait that powers up spears, which, as you may know, are the weapons used by Tsukasa, ruler of the Empire of Might. It also has original collab skills like Kanyu Spear Style, which gives a chance to deal an attack that can't be guarded against, and Empire of Might, which strengthens attack damage according to the number of enemies present. In addition, it comes with Dark Critical Rays, which gives a massive leg up to dark physical attacks.
はい、じゃあ、マキとからね、紹介してもらいましたけども、今回新規追加される、一つ目のアークになりますけど、ブルーカの警告っていうことね。まあ、イラストもね、 原作のまさにこうアニメ第2期を象徴するかのようなアニメのイラストになってますんでね、これね、パッと見でもね、結構やっぱ欲しいなって思いました。もちろんね、パラメータとか取得できるスキルに関しても、象徴的なものももちろんついてますし、強力なものついてますんで、ぜひチェックしてほしいなと思います。Okay,
so now for our final arc.
Dang, another LR. 1,000 skies.
Would you believe it? We're not able to share the artwork with you just yet, but don't worry, we'll be posting it on social media before long. This arc has a trait that enhances the special science magic from the Dr. Stone collab. In addition, it has the ability 100 Tails, which can enhance your attribute weaknesses. Additionally, Baton to the Future is uniquely able to carry on the abilities of fallen allies. In particular, it carries over their HP recovery and skill charge. All of these arcs are coming soon.
Coming soon!
Holy crap!
あの、そうだね。アーク名とかで、あの、原作のあそこですよって割とこう分かるね、皆さんもいるのかなというふうに思いますけどね。はい。まあ結構象徴的なシーンなんでね。注目ですよ。まあぜひ、あの、情報交換で少々お待ちください。All right,
that about wraps it up for our description of the units and arcs. So you're probably excited to get them as soon as possible, and I want to share the schedule with you now. First, from March 2nd, we'll see the return of three units and the two arcs that were already released, plus Genasagiri, Empire of Might. Then from March 9th, Chrome and 100 Nights and 1000 Skies will make their appearance. All right, so now we're going to let you know a little bit about the gacha that will be part of the collab. You know, I think here on screen, you've got a bunch of information that tells you about all of the different gacha that are going to be appearing. We'll be sharing some more details in the game notices, in in-game notices around the time.
All right, so it looks like we're going to have a two-part gacha. Revival pickup gacha. This is going to be the main characters, and I believe the first part of it will be Genasaguri and one LR arc, and then the second part, which would be Dr. Stone unit, and the secondary LR arc. Don't know how I feel about this. I was really hoping that it would be all five units, and I didn't know about the new LR arc till today, so that is going to be insane. This thing is going to be loaded, so they're probably going to have two separate gachas. So it kind of makes it a little bit more fair, so you know, you're not able to pull everything out of one banner. I totally get why they're doing that from a business perspective, but I was really hoping they didn't, but it is what it is. So March 9th is when we're going to get the rest of the stuff, which, you know, honestly, I guess the best way to do this will be just kind of hold off maybe. Maybe do a couple of pulls for the first part, and then the second round, go ahead and really kind of concentrate on what you want to get. After, you know, a couple of days of reviewing the characters and seeing other people post stuff, I will be most likely trying to get as many as I can so that I can share with y'all which ones I think are really good to go for. But from what I'm seeing so far is that everything is actually really good. They have a purpose. I myself am really excited for Chrome and, well, honestly, Senku. But I'm really interested in to see who, again, is going to be capable of. So it looks like pretty basic stuff. These units will be coming out in order.
Alright,
so absolutely. Thank you for that, Take-san. And I want to jump into now talking a little bit about the event story, Science User from Another World. So, in the collaboration event story, Senku, Ishigami, and Kohaku find themselves in the world of Last Cloudia, where magic and technology exist side by side. Thrown into a land of 10 billion percent fantasy, Senku and Kohaku enlist the main cast of Last Cloudia to help return to the Stone World. Alright, so, as your rewards for playing the first time, you'll be able to get a collab unit exchange ticket and a 10-spin event arc ticket for playing. So the collab unit exchange ticket is a ticket that could be exchanged for either one of the for the part one gacha, which contains Gen and the existing units, or the part two gacha that contains Chrome and the three existing units. All right, and in addition, we have the 10-spin event arc ticket, a ticket that's guaranteed to contain the SR arc Stone World, as well as collab unit souls and power-up materials. So all players will get rewards according to how many of the following items everyone crafts. Sulfur drug and gunpowder. The rewards improve as you craft more items. The more sulfur drug collected, the more mother souls you could get. Gunpowder allows you to get tons of event tickets. So aim for 100% collab arc ether. Oh, absolutely. I mean, there's so many little elements
in there.
Okay, so we're going to touch now on our trading space crafting items. When you make the following four items, it's possible to trade for great rewards in the trading space. You have soap, cola, nitro fluid, and the manganese battery. So in the trading space, we will have a special crafting system, and as a result, all items will be available in the trading space from the very beginning of the event, rather than, you know, sometimes they're split into a first half and a second half. That will not be the case this time around. I want to touch a little bit as well on the equipment. Previous equipment is going to be available there in the trading space. For example, the Ishigami Village Katana, Kohaku's Shield, and Suika's Helmet, as will new equipment, yeah, Suika's Helmet, right? As well as some new equipment like the Bluff of a Gun, Ishigami Village Alcohol, the Sextant, and Carbon Fiber Shield. Yeah, you'll also get some, you also have the chance to get some collab gacha tickets, like the Dr. Stone ticket part 1 and 2. And in addition to that, you'll also be able to power up your units with collab unit prisms and unit souls. Also, there's one thing that I want to mention in addition to that, which is that the Tsukasa Shishio Challenge event, which some of you might remember from the first time, is going to be coming back. And you will be able to get, you know, a bunch of materials from that quest.
いや、交換でもさ、すげえいいよね。そのなんかさ、前回もちろんさ、追加してた装備品に加えて、ま、今回新たに装備品も追加してるっていう点もあるし、ま、ガチャ式に関してもね、交換所の方針に追加されてる。さらには栄翔とかも入ってるね。これはね、ぜひね、やり込んでるユーザーさんとかは、ぜひゲットしたアイテムかなというふうに思いますし、ま、盛り盛りでね、ま、かなり魅力的かなって思います。
Let's touch on one of the other fun features of the Dr. Stone collab event, which is going to be collab tours. When you go in collab tours, you'll be able to collect loads of power-up materials. It's possible to get more items there than in even regular event quests. So there will be 6 places where these tours are available. When you go, you'll want to bring Dr. Stone units along with you to get bonus drops. Tours complete after a fixed amount of time, so be sure to check on them regularly. Okay, and is so often the case, we will be holding some special promos which allow you to train your new units and arcs. You know, I don't know, could you tell people a little bit about those?
あ、そうだね。この機会にね、ぜひこう、EXP も獲得できるし、AP もね、稼げるし、あとは能力ゲットとかね、ああいうところで大ゲットやりますので、Ability Piece とかね、ガンガン開放できる、そんな機会になってます。ぜひ活かしてほしいなと思います。
And that brings us to our login bonuses. So there will be a 2-part login bonus where you can get tons of collab gacha tickets and crystals. Log in daily to be sure that you get them all. In the first part, you will be able to get a Dr. Stone ticket part 1, while in the second, you will be able to get a Dr. Stone ticket part 2. So on social media, we're going to be giving a bunch of real-life goodies away to you. This is just a reminder that the collab period will start on March 2nd and go all the way through March 16th. And remember, you're guaranteed to get 1 arc and unit just for playing, so don't miss it.
はい、じゃあね、今日も盛り盛りの情報をお送りしてまいりましたけども、コラボユニット復刻しますし、ゲンとクロム入りますし、イベントもやって、キャンペーンも張って、もう盛り盛りだなっていうので、盛りだくさんで今日のね、動画をお伝えしましたけども、ぜひコラボ期間、ラストクラウディでは盛り上げてまいりますんで、チェックしてみてください。よろしくお願いします。
Okay, so thank you so much for watching today.
All right, guys, I definitely don't want to hit that 30-minute mark on this video. I'm not a fan of long videos like this. But yeah, so it looks like the gacha tickets are going to be distributed between the couple weeks that it will be available. Looks like we're getting a decent amount of crystals along with good amount of tickets for part 1 and 2. So judging by the way this is going to be working, looks like we're only guaranteed 1 unit, and you're going to get to decide whether you want to pull it from the part 1 or the part 2 area. Guys, I would definitely hold off. I know, you know, it's really exciting to probably get that unit ticket and kind of just blow it on something, but go ahead and do some analyzing. Make sure that you know what you're trying to get before you do it. It's going to be interesting. but yeah, and also, guys, I've been getting a lot of comments and stuff like that about the prisms and people missing out on the alchemy. Make sure you guys are checking out with that. I do in every single video, I always try to get you guys to make sure that you are checking that stuff, that you're not missing out on content, because when it disappears, and we don't know when we're going to get it back. We will also be doing some guides on the sulfur, because it is a little tricky at sometimes if some people do not understand it. And then also the tours, they are 100% right about the tours. Make sure you guys are looking at that. I will be going over this event, pretty much covering this event 100% throughout. So any little things that I can find to help you guys out and make sure no one misses absolutely anything. Even newer players, definitely reach out to me if you're having trouble with certain kind of content. I will definitely do my best to get your friend number, and we'll go ahead and figure out, you know, a way to make sure that we can go ahead and clear some stuff that you're having trouble with. Just go ahead and drop it in the comments below, and we will go from there. But like I said, I will be covering this whole event And don't be afraid to ask for help if you need it. And join the Discord as well. We have a lot of great guys in there that are willing to help out anybody and everybody. Great group of guys that I've met over the past couple months. So, but I am super excited for this collab. Hats off to Aidis for, you know, this amazing stuff. They didn't have to do two extra characters, and they did. They didn't have to give us a free character, and they did. We're also getting that free SR arc, which is really good, along with two new LRs. I mean, this thing is jam-packed with stuff, guys. I'm so excited for this. So that's all actually I have for you today. I'm already hitting that 30-minute mark. I don't want to go any further than that, but make sure that you guys like and subscribe to my content if you do enjoy it. Every day I'm trying to, you know, do my best on getting stuff upgraded for my rig so that I can get higher quality stuff for you. I am weeks away from getting there, so be patient with me, guys. I have new capture cards, new computer coming in. So like I said, it's gonna be great stuff for this year. And I want to also thank everybody who has liked and watched all my videos, and I've had a blast, you know, meeting all of you guys. Just so much fun, and I can't wait for the future holds. But once again, thank you so much. And guys, go to Aidis's page and please like and subscribe to their content. They have great stuff, and it seems like they're a great group of guys. So thank you guys for watching today. You guys have a great and safe night.